A vulture pecked at this guy's mouth, making him awakened. He threw the bird away, it fell out of the cliff. He started to feel wrong. At this time, Kada slowly looked down. He found himself lying on a cliff. Kada now didn't know what to do. He could neither climb up nor climb down. He shouted loudly for help, but received no reply. He started to climb the rest of the way down the cliff, but slipped. He held firmly to avoid falling down. The situation became even worse. Kada couldn't climb up anymore, so he could only stay there. At this time, dark clouds appeared in the sky. A sudden heavy rainfall caused the ravine below to flood. Kada was both cold and hungry, but couldn't do anything. It became slippery and Kada slipped his foot. He used all his strength to cling to the cliff. Kada looked down, the water was rising. Suddenly he came up with an idea. Kada still clung to the cliff. Until the rainwater was high enough, he jumped down. The next day, Kada woke up and he was still alive. At this moment, an extreme pain came from his left foot. It turned out that when he jumped down, his foot broke so he couldn't walk. Kada could only hold back the pain and crawled to the puddle, taking a few sips of the dirty water. At this time, Kada had no other choice because he was too thirsty. After taking off the shoes, Kada found that his foot was swollen. He used some stone to splint his injured foot. His bone was straightened. Kada made a brace to fix the injured foot. Reaching the top of the cliff, Kada found the memorial cairn left by his tribe. He realized he had to travel back to the village by himself. At this time, from behind came wolf's growl. As Kada turned around, a pack of ferocious wolves rushed toward him. Kada hurriedly ran away on his broken foot. In this desolate place, it was very hard to find a place to hide. Kada had to temporarily sleep on a tree. The next day, when he woke up, Kada picked up a worm and tried to swallow it. As soon as he finished eating, the wolves came again. Before Kada could calm down, they rushed toward him. Kada climbed on the tree in panic, but one of the wolves bit his injured foot. Kada couldn't stand anymore. He didn't think much and frantically stabbed the wolf. He tried to climb on the tree. The wolves couldn't climb up and the wounded wolf collapsed. Kada fell asleep on the tree. The next day when he woke up, the pack had left. Kada made a handmade spear. He stepped toward the wounded wolf and intended to kill it. When he was too about to do it, he heard the wolf's moan. Kada was always the most honest person in his tribe and also the most unaccomplished man. He had been taught to hunt countless times by his father, but he never dared to kill anything. Kada still couldn't do it this time. Moreover, Kada didn't have the heart to let the wolf die. He finally decided to help it. But the wolf kept growling and made Kada scared. He used a rope to tie its mouth to avoid being bitten. After that, Kada carried the wolf away. Night fell, he found a cave and treated the wolf's wounded. Early the next morning, Kada left to find some medical leaves to treat the wolf. When he came back, the wolf had untied its mouth and began to growl at Kada. Kada stepped backwards. But he gathered his courage and slowly approached the wolf. He gave it a bowl of water to drink. Kada gradually gained the wolf's trust by giving it water, and then food. Kada disinfected the wolf's wound. The wolf was very delighted, it looked very cute at this moment. In this deserted steppe, an injured person couldn't survive on his own. The next day, Kada found a lovely rabbit. But this time, although it was very cute, Kada had to kill it. He brought the rabbit back to the cave and tried to make fire. The wolf sat nearby, it looked like wanting to steal the rabbit, but was stopped by Kada. He frantically tore up the rabbit in front of the wolf, establishing himself as dominant. Kada finally looked like a real man. After that, he managed to make fire. In the evening, Kada had grilled meat to eat, the taste of cooked meat made him happy. The wolf kept staring at him. Kada scolded it, but eventually gave it a piece of meat. Kada's foot finally recovered, he could continue on his journey. He wanted to take the mat used to bandage the wolf in case he needed it. Unexpectedly, the wolf took it from Kada. After a while fighting over it, Kada was able to take the mat. And then bid farewell to it. He wanted to set out for the village without the wolf, but it followed him. He shouted at it and told it to not come, the wolf immediately lied down. When Kada was about to leave, the wolf stood up and continued to follow him. No matter how hard Kada tried to stop it, the wolf still followed him. Just like that, Kada had to have an unwilling companion. Later on, Kada and the wolf became best friend. They learnt to hunt animals together, making the hunting much easier. At night, when they slept, the wolf lied next to Kada, they were like a family. Day by day, their friendship became closer and closer. When Kada found the wolf stinking, he led it to the river and cleaned it. After that, when seeing a fish in the water, the wolf rushed to grab it. Kada then named the wolf Alpha. As the season changed into winter, food was scarce. Fortunately, Kada had his Alpha. On that day, Kada accidentally stepped on thin ice. The ice broke and he fell through. He was swept away by the water. Alpha rushed toward to rescue Kata. It frantically broke the ice. But it was too weak to break the ice. Kata took out his knife and broke the ice and surfaced. Alpha helped him climb up. Kata took off all his clothes. While drying his clothes, he could only hug Alpha to keep warm. That day, a snowstorm came. They could only hide in a cave. But unexpectedly, inside they were confronted and attacked by a ferocious lion. Kata wanted to run away, but it was too late. At the critical moment, Alpha rushed in and saved Kata. But it could no way fight the lion, and was severely wounded. At the last minute, Kata raised his bow. After taking a deep breath, the arrow went straight into the lion. The fight was finally over. Alpha stepped toward Kata, but very quickly, it collapsed. Alpha was fatally wounded. In the cave, Kata grilled the lion's meat. Alpha lied next to him, its body was full of wounds. But Kata now didn't have medical leaves. They continued on their journey. Under the severe snowstorm, they were almost exhausted. At this time, Alpha's life was like a candle in the wind. And Kata's face was also very pale. When Alpha finally couldn't walk, Kata carried the wolf. Kata eventually found his village, while nearly passing out from exhaustion. His appearance in the village made everyone in the tribe extremely surprised. His father hugged him and cried with joy. Before falling into a coma, Kata told his father to save Alpha at any price. The first thing Kata did after regaining consciousness was finding Alpha. The wolf was still alive, but it was very weak. As the village healer tended to Alpha's wounds, Alpha delivered a litter of puppies. It turned out that Alpha had been pregnant for a long time. Kata was very touched. After a few months, the puppies grew up in the care of Alpha and Kata. They would always be here with the tribe and Kata. Years later, everyone in the tribe had a wolf by their side. The final image of the film showed the tribe and their domesticated wolves hunting together.